This week's Ask Dr. Durie comes from a patient who wants to know, is dara being used in the frontline setting? The answer to that is a decisive yes. And so the first part of the answer is, what is dara? Well, dara is daratumumab, which is the anti-CD38 monoclonal antibody, which has been an amazing new immune therapy introduced in the last few years. Daratumumab was first evaluated in the relapsed refractory setting and produced remarkably good results as a single agent. It was subsequently tested in a variety of combinations, including in the earlier relapse setting. And one particular combination, daratumumab combined with pomalidomide and dexamethasone, turned out to be unusually synergistic and successful, and this combination has also been approved by the FDA. And so, what about in the frontline setting? Well, there have been a number of trials, some completed and a number ongoing right now. The first two trials which caught attention were daratumumab Velcade melflanprednisone, DARA-VMP, the results of which were presented by Mary V. Mateos at ASH in 2017. This combination showed remarkable efficacy compared to the VMP alone, and I think can become a new standard of care, particularly in Europe. However, this is not a combination used widely in the US, and so this past year at ASH 2018, there was tremendous interest in the results of a new trial called the GAIA trial, which evaluated daratumumab, Revlimid and Dex as compared to Revlimid and Dex. And so the results were remarkably good, showing dramatic increased efficacy with results almost identical to the results with Velcade, Revlimid and Dex compared to RevDex in the frontline setting. An update of the SWOG 777 trial results were also presented at ASH in 2018. And so one has now two completed trials where daratumumab in the frontline setting has proved to be remarkably effective. And so one is expecting many more to show efficacy in the non-transplant setting as well in the transplant setting. And so the bottom line for this patient is that certainly daratumumab is being used in the frontline setting with sufficient success that it will in fact prove to be a new standard of care in the frontline setting in a variety of combinations, and so something that will be here to stay for many years, particularly since we have in parallel trials using dara in the sub-Q fashion, subcutaneous injection versus the IV, which will make it even easier to use. And so this will be a therapy which is around to stay and will be part of what we will come to use as the backbone for myeloma therapies.